distance station on space to ground.
Go Antares! Welcome to Space to Ground, I'm Dan Hewitt. This week started off how all weeks should, with a rocket launch. Orbital ATK's Antares lifted off Monday morning, illuminating the Virginia night sky and delivering the Cygnus spacecraft into orbit. Following the textbook launch and three-day trip circling the globe, Cygnus arrived at the station on Thursday and was snagged by NASA astronaut Scott Tingle. The vehicle, packed with about 7,400 pounds of cargo, was attached to the Earth-facing side of the Unity module before the crew opened the hatch and got to work. And coming soon to a space station near you, one of the coldest spots in the universe. The Cold Atom Laboratory is a physics experiment that will be producing clouds of ultra-cold atoms, called Bose-Einstein condensates, or BECs, where atoms behave more like waves instead of particles. To do all this, atoms will be chilled to about 10 billionths of a degree above absolute zero, which is about 10 billion times colder than the average temperature of deep space. Thanks to the station's microgravity environment, scientists will be able to observe the BECs for up to 10 seconds, way longer than the fractions of a second we see in similar experiments here on Earth. Scientists are hoping to address some fundamental questions in science, like the nature of gravity, dark matter, and dark energy, and could also help improve technologies like atomic clocks used in space navigation, or quantum sensors on spacecraft used for things like monitoring Earth's climate or the makeup of other planets and asteroids. This week's Twitter question comes from Mark Wilson, who wants to know how we weigh astronauts in microgravity. Well, a scale isn't much use, so we had to turn to some fundamental physics. Newton's second law of motion teaches us we can calculate force by multiplying an object's mass by its acceleration. Using the Space Linear Acceleration Mass Measurement Device, or SLAM, we can use two springs to generate a known force against an astronaut and measure the resulting acceleration. With two of the three variables in our equation now known, we can calculate mass. We hope you like what we've done with the place, and keep sending in your questions using the hashtag SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.
Off the Earth, for the Earth. Space to ground.